Let's now talk about the do while loop. So far we have discussed about the while and the for loop statement. The do while loop is different from the other two loops in the sense that the Boolean expression or the test condition is done only when the body of the loop executes at least once. At least this is very important, because suppose you are giving the user certain options. Initially, the user will have not entered any option. If you use a while loop, the body of the loop may never get executed because the initial value itself may be false. With the do while loop, you ensure that the body of the loop is executed at least once. So, the difference between the other loop is the testing is done after the loop body executes at least once. With any loop statement, whether it's the for, while or the do while, please do use this compound bracket to avoid any confusion, and also especially in case of the do while loop, to avoid confusion with the while loop. So in this program, I'm going to read the menu option entered by the user. Option is 0. So what I'm doing here is I have do. This is the compound statement. What I've said is, as long as the option is not equal to 0, keep running this loop again and again. Now, if I had used the while loop, this body would have not got executed even once, because the condition would have been false at the very beginning. But by using the do while loop, the advantage I have is I am asking the user do enter a menu option and 0 to quit. So the user can enter 1, 2, 3 or 4. And then I'm reading the option. As long as the option is not 0, it will keep doing this body of statements again and again. Let's say the user entered 2, then it option becomes 2 and I could call the module to do the subtraction. Suppose the user is done with testing your program, he or she enters 0. Once option becomes 0, 0 not equal to 0 is false, because 0 is equal to 0. Then I will come out of the loop. An important point with the do while loop is, after the condition is tested, there is a semicolon, unlike the while or the for loop. So please do not forget to put the semicolon in the do while loop after the testing of the condition. So this should give you an idea about how a do while loop is used.